Hello, my friends. It's a very warm welcome from me. My name is Red Rob UK. What's up here, building there? And welcome back. Now, obviously, from the other day, we're doing side missions in Glenumbra. And usually, every zone usually has about, on average, about 40 side missions, well, missions and side missions to get through, so we will be spending a bit of time. I just saw purple glow in there and I'm wondering what it was. Bum nog's being put on guard duty. So, but we'll get off and make a start. We're up in Alcar. Oh, there's some fishing. Altcraft and around the middle part of the map. I'll just show you. Around here, and obviously we were picking up all the side missions as we went along. Yeah, we shall carry on. There's lots of side missions around here.
I'm going to play that fool orc alive.
But this is the one we want.
What has that fool orc gotten himself into now? Recruit Gorak, a new initiate sent from Wayrest along with a tide of untested soldiers. And he really is green. He's an orc. There's not many of them in the Lion Guard. He got himself lost in the swamp, again. He tried to show up the other recruits and recover General Gaudier's lost dispatch. Listen, I can't spare many soldiers. If you head out into the swamp, can you keep an eye out for Gorak? Please, let me know if you find Recruit Gorak. He may be a little overzealous, but he means well. I think. Gorak's eager. Maybe too eager. He wants to be in the Lion Guard so badly that he'll crawl over broken glass to impress us. His attitude hasn't sat well with the other officers. I'm the fourth commander he's been assigned to. Gorak has a fire and a passion. I respect that. I just need to find a way to temper his enthusiasm and harness it before he gets himself or his fellow guards hurt.
Yeah, okie dokie. Let's go find our bud. Where is he? Somewhere over here, then.
Comrade, a word.
Where's Bobbitt? Some of this, do you? Not much of assassins, are they? Right, so he's around here somewhere. Gorak.
Oh,
doing too bad now on his weapon damage, my joy. I mean, hunting straight each job. Let's make a bit of a difference. Rufus with us. Let's rob the place while we're here. It's not nailed down. Wrong button. And I've already done me research and my horse. First thing I done when I come
greetings,
on.
Citizen. I seem to have suffered a temporary setback. These bloodthorn Cretans ambushed me, and while I was on a mission of incredible importance, there were dozens of them. But I didn't go down without a fight. What will the Line Guard do without me?
Just turn me telly down a bit.
Sits before you represents the future of the Line Guard. I am Recruit Gorok, pride of New Orsinium. Please untie me. We have work to do. We must I took
he's a
beating
brave
when the
bloodthorns
grabbed me. I won't be much help in a fight, but I'll cheer you on.
Come on, Gorag, let's get you back safely. Leave it to the big boys.
Thank you. I'll take the dispatch to Captain Vistra. Find me later.
Really,
I owe you
dear.
A drink.
Great news. Great news indeed.
The guild has need of you, comrade.
Oh, go away, you stalker. Can you use quick, honey?
To believe you're the one to thank for Gorak's safe return. He even retrieved the general's dispatch. Recruit Gorak claims that you helped him defeat dozens of cultists and recover the dispatch from a foul necromancer. Is this true?
Yeah.
Incredible. I knew you had potential, Gorak, but I never imagined you were so capable. Thank you for your help, friend. Though it sounds like Gorak didn't really need it.
Nah, it didn't.
Gorak, you truly distinguished yourself this day. You're no longer a recruit. Welcome to the Lion Guard, Private Gorak.
This is the happiest day of my life.
Right. Things we do for fellow orcs, eh? Right, where are we off to next? Jog.
There's an urgent task for you.
Right, just in case you haven't noticed, I see this. Straps and all that on me horse. You get them for reaching level 20. don't do anything, they're only a visual thing. It's like when you upgrade your carry weight, you get to level 20, you get saddlebags. And stamina, you get like face armor. Okay, I'm gonna have a chat to this girl. What's the matter, love?
What will I do without you? Why would they kill a defenseless old man? They came in the night. They came right into the lighthouse and attacked us in our sleep. I ran here and hid. You aren't going to make me leave, are you? I feel safer here, please. It was the Bloodthorns. Oh, poor Papa. I left everything behind. I don't even have his dear old pipe to remember him by. If I just had that one small thing, maybe I...
Don't worry, love. There's one thing we love doing. Me and Bum Nug is killing Bloodthorn. I'm picking up crap as well, by the way. Okay. Give these a bit of zap of that. I'm liking this DPS character. So I don't usually play DPS, I usually play tank, but I'm actually enjoying it. Getting the enemies down quick. Oh, this is all piped there, look. Well, he's not going to need this stuff now, is he? Shit myself down.
I'm glad you're helping, Alec. Come, mortal. Do a favor for this poor, weary spirit. My daughter is lost to her grief. How can she send you here to a haunt of vile cultists to retrieve a pipe? Sheer folly. She should have something of real. For years, I've been hiding gold under a tree southwest of the lighthouse. Dig it up, give it to my daughter. Then she needs to go to my brother in Crosswich. There she can start anew.
Okay, Mr. Ghostman. I'm trying to kill you here. Oh. He's already dead. Happy the other day, no, because I don't know whether you caught last Thursday's stream, but we're actually over doing a bit of PvP in Citadel. We had a good night, but I played it in third person. They were all made up. I don't know why, like.
thought Papa was nearby, but now, nothing. Do you have his pipe? I just want to hold on to him, just a little longer. He appeared? He appeared and spoke about me? I recognize this satchel. What's inside it? Oh, Papa, ever the pragmatist. There's enough here to get supplies in Aldcroft. Then I can go on to Crosswich.
Go on then. Oh, can't steal them. Anything still? No, still can't steal. Right, that's another one bites the dust. I wonder what was going on with his face then. It's a mask, isn't it? Right. What's next on the list? Alright. What is Bob there going fishing
off? An entire flock of harpies with their bare
hands. Yo, Bob.
The fighters' guild look like amateurs.
The guild has need of you, comrade.
Beware, stranger. The Bloodthorn cult prowls the fens.
I'm no warrior. I'm a chandler. Candles don't make very good weapons, you know. A group of us. We were fleeing from the trouble in Camlord, but we ran into a fresh set of problems when we got to this blasted fen. As we made camp, some Bloodthorn cultists swooped in. They grabbed the women traveling with us and dragged them off. Our leader, Guy LeBlanc, heard them talking about a coven. That means witches and trouble. Maybe you could talk to LeBlanc. He's around here somewhere. Sure use the help. We are way out of our element here. Go to Aldcroft, he says. It'll be safer, he says. We shouldn't have listened to LeBlanc. We're from Camlord. There's been trouble there. I thought maybe things would be a bit more safe in Aldcroft. No place is safe these days, it seems.
There's none there now. They sorted our out.
I will never forgive myself. That is a bit of bright news amid all this mayhem. I promised Elodie we would return to our nice little home in Camlorn when the troubles were over. She's returned safely. More or less. He's usually a take-charge sort of fellow. It was his idea to head to Aldcroft, so he feels responsible for all this. His sister was among the women they grabbed.
Right. Slave trade, isn't it? Can't be having that on our watch.
Suggested fleeing to Aldcroft. Brilliant idea, LeBlanc. Now they're gone. All the women in our group, kidnapped by cultists and dragged off into the fen. Yes, we should have stayed in Camlorn.
Yeah, we know. Come on.
My sister would still be with me. We thought we'd go to Aldcroft, but ran into trouble here in the fens before we got there. Bloodthorn cultists swarmed in.
How many times did he go on about it?
I heard them say something about a hag coven. In the North Fens. My sister Bethany was fighting them as they dragged her off. I don't know what to do. I feel useless. I'm not used to this sort of life. I sent the others to the Weirus camp nearby. Cultists, bogs, bugs as big as my head. Why, oh why did I ever leave the city?
Oh, stop whinging.
Bloodthorn? I don't know what you're doing out here, but you're a sight for sore eyes. Now hurry up and cut me loose.
You
no,
bossy.
I'm the Queen of the Nords. Of course I'm from Camlorn. Did my brother Gee send you? I gave the cultists a hard time, so they tied me up. They took the other women away, though. I think they traded them to the bog hags. The Bloodthorns have an arrangement with the hags. Something about exchanging us for their help against the Weird. They even have a contract. I saw them arguing over it earlier. It should be around here somewhere. Please try to find my companions. These cultists are insane. But the hags... who knows what they're capable of. I'll go find my brother. Poor Sod is useless without me.
Dragonite there. Ladies, run, run, I've got your back. Come on, Rufus.
Sister and the other women made it here. Everyone's a bit rattled and tired, but otherwise they don't seem hurt. Thank you. Weirus Emily says a hag named Mother Murp was likely behind the abduction of the women. I wish we could stop her before she tries this again. All this danger and adventure. We're so not cut out for this. Mother Murp is a coven of hags. That's what the Weirus has told me. The coven hunts women to convert into hags or thralls. The Weirus has told me about the Reach woman, Sibelic. She knows how to deal with Mother Murk. She's staying with the Weiruses at the Northern Enclave. Meeting you was a bright spot in this otherwise dark adventure. If you can stop Mother Murk, that'll be one less thing for us to worry about. You can find Sibelic in the Northern Weird Camp.
I've had enough talking to you, you're boring. Right. Fishing bait. You know I like me fishing. I This is actually a player's house here. Quick nose. Why you want a house here? I don't know, but. £250,000, so it looks like furnished. I'll be adding that to my collection somehow. Yeah. Oh, there's a way sign there. Pick that up first, I think. Right. Talk to this lady up here. We like these way wrists or whatever they're called.
So you've come to the bog at last. I've waited for your arrival. It was written on the stones and in the sky. Fate has led you here, just as I have foreseen it. You wish to resolve the conflict between the Weird and the Coven. Mother Merc's anger and darkness run deep, even for a Hagraven. She's powerful. And leads the Coven through fear and pain. You'll need this charm to defeat her, for she can siphon vitality from even the strongest foe. Kill the lesser hags and drain their power into this charm. But use the charm only when Merc tries to siphon your life force. Don't waste its power. You can find the hags to the west. Just protect that charm. It is your best.
Okay. Oh, it's hag killing we go. Bloody hell happened there. That. green thing. What's he got in the treehouse? Any more knocking around that I can kill? Oh. Bad idea, boys. I haven't even bumped into any crocodiles yet. I'm talking to the devil. She gets the posh house.
Returned, and you are victorious, just as I have foreseen it.
I sensed her departure. The shadows cast by her destructive anger will fade from these fens in time. Perhaps you will find peace in whatever lies beyond this plane. You did well, I think. She was a dark and dangerous creature, to be sure. I do not mourn her, but I wish her to be at peace. Mother Merc's influence on the hags was strong. With her gone, the balance of the fens will change. Indeed, with Mother Merc gone, the hags will wither and the weird will prosper. You, however, have somewhere else to be. I see a long road ahead of you, traveler. Tread carefully.
Hey. Level 32. Okay, let's see what we've got. Dice stamps. Ooh, what are these? That one is roughly everything covered in the middle section. So now we are going to the top. Top of the map around here. We'll use that waste shrine. Kill this frog. Okay, so we're looking for done this one, to be honest. Yeah, I've done this one, part of a mission. The corpse horde. Switch. Make a start up there. Thank you. Bit of a drab pub, this, isn't it? Right, dude.
I'm glad to see you again, and I can certainly use your help. I came to Crosswich when I heard the Red Rooks had taken over the town. What happened at Eaglesbrook, I vowed to fight the Red Rooks with every fiber of my being. The Red Rooks have taken over Crosswich. I plan to help these people get back their town. I've roused some of them, but we still don't have the numbers to face the bandits. My revenge starts here. I will find a way to make the bandits pay. The people are afraid. They need to see that the town leaders are going to take a stand. We need the support of the town council. The few that haven't been dragged off to the mines have to show the people how to stand up to these villains. We need the support of the town council. Without them, the rest of the townsfolk will be too afraid to fight back. Of course, I'll answer what I can. The most prominent of the remaining councillors are Councillors Virgil, Donella, and Theodore. Look for them around town and convince them to help us. We're finished before we even get started. About what you'd expect, it weighs on me. That's why I made my way to Crosswich. I think I can help the people here.
If you forgot, he's the lad we actually rescued at Eaglesbrook. We were gonna kill him, but we rescued him. That's how we roll. Right.
Someone has to stand up to these Red Rook villains.
Oh, I might as well do this one while I'm here as well.
Did you meet with Damien Sellen? He's got the right idea. The Red Rook enforcers have threatened, extorted, or beaten us at every turn. They claim it's for our own protection, but they just want our gold. They're not even honest about their thievery. I say it's time to fight. That's what I wanted to hear. If you stand up to those greedy bastards, it will show the rest of the town that we can take them.
Right. Kill two birds with one stone, as they say.
Everything he demanded to keep the townsfolk safe, even surrendered his own house. They killed Isabel, our beloved mayor. They killed him in cold blood. Weren't you listening? They killed him. First they ran the watch out of town, then they took over our businesses. Now they murdered the mayor. They extort, threaten,
right,
and murder
calm
their
down.
Content. And no one can stop.
Are you mad? Everyone who tried is either dead or enslaved in the mines. We can't win. The Red Rooks are too powerful. I just lost my best friend. I don't want to lose him. You didn't even know him. You... No, you're right. Isif wasn't a soldier. But he was a strategist. He was trying to work around these bastards. The least I can do is continue what he started. I'll do whatever.
Looted this place well. You're calving for it there for you, little shitbag.
Die for interfering with the Red Rooks!
Oh, boy.
This town belongs to my town. Now.
No, it's not. It's mine. I'm the lord around here. Be free, peasant.
Who are you? Another Red Rook dog barking for its masters? I've got bad news for you, hound. I'm fed up. Whatever you want, the answer is no. Oh? Well, why don't you say so? The Red Rooks
couldn't get a bleeding red, and that's why.
Forcing the miners to work until they drop. You want to stop the Red Rooks? How about running them through with a sword? That'd be damn useful.
Not sure I entirely trust that young fellow. But standing around doing nothing doesn't sit well with me either. I'm not much use in a battle, but I can spread the word. We'll raise an army to deal with these Red Rooks. Let Selen know I'm with him. We'll stick a hot poker in the backside of that pompous Sternus Gelves and the rest of his beef-witted Red Rooks.
Yeah. He talks the talk. Right. There's somebody getting harassed up there.
At last, I'm free.
Yeah, go on, do a runner. Did I save this guy before?
This town belongs to the Red Rooks now. Flank, now!
Where's the other dude?
You arrived in the nick of time.
Did you teach those Red Rooks a lesson? I don't know what happened to us. We're mountain folk and miners. We shouldn't be so easily cowed. You've given us back our courage.
Mara, why is this happening? What did we do to deserve this trouble? You better go. They'll be back at any moment to demand more gold from me. Are you mad? Selen wants the people to rise up and fight. That would be suicide. Still,
did he match
the Red Rooks harass me every day, demanding more and more gold. Oh no, I think I hear them now. You probably think I'm just foolish, imagining Red Rooks around every corner. But those nasty bandits are rude, greedy, and dangerous. I don't want to end up poor and destitute. Your willingness to help shames me. You're right. I must be strong if we are ever to feel safe again. I'll find a way to help you and Selen. I can spread the word that we're going...
All right. You're going to spread the word. I'll do all the fighting, as usual. Right, he's back in the pub, isn't he?
I have some good news and some bad news. The good news is that the people have begun to rally around the idea of resisting the Red Rooks. The bad news is the Red Rooks have taken notice. This is just the thing we need to inspire the people. Now the Resistance can get to work on getting rid of the Red Rook. Anyone who stands up to Sternus Gelves ends up in the Crosswitch Mines. He works his prisoners to death down there. We need to close the mines and take that resource away from the Red Rooks. The Red Rooks took control of the mines when they arrived. They worked the miners night and day. And they also use the mines as a prison for anyone who causes trouble. Counselor Leah, Smith Suriel, and Len the Innkeeper were all sent into the mine. That would be perfect. If you can free Len, Suriel, and Counselor Leah, the entire town will gain confidence. Let them know we're organizing. Maybe help some of the miners as well. Then meet me behind the inn when you're finished. Talk to any miners you can get close to without arousing suspicion. Let them know we're organizing. Or just kill the Red Rooks in the mine. Miners will try to escape if you clear a path for them. Your actions will raise the town's morale, I'm sure of it. I heard you spoke to Marenter Gent. It means we'll soon have more strong hands to help us oust these black-hearted rogues.
Right. This is the one and only time you'll actually get it. Oh, there's a Sky Shark. Sky Shark's come first. By a book. It's like the one and only time you can actually get in here. Peasant, be free.
I'm getting out of here.
leg here.
I'm getting out of here.
Keeping myself
busy. There's only one of them.
I'm getting out of here. Cards around, you can do a runner.
Join him when the Red Rooks captured me. It's time to finish what I started.
get out of Dodge. Sky shard anyway. Shouldn't forget when you come out of that mine, the sky shard, if you haven't already picked it up. Sound surprised, don't they?
Praises from a number of rescued miners. Well done.
Blaze. Dead? That's good news. I've sent some of the miners to Counselor Virgil to recover. As soon as they're able, they'll return to the mine and clear out the rest of the Red Rooks. Well done, my friend. It's time. The people of Crosswich have taken up arms and are ready to retake their town. But first, he's taken over the mayor's house. Since the resistance started, he never leaves the place. You'll have to fight through his personal guards to reach him. Fortunately, you'll have some help, if you want. The resistance has grown thanks to you. If you want help, use this whistle in front of the mayor's house. Anyone nearby will come to help. Find me when Gelves is finished. Meanwhile, we'll start removing the rooks out here. We've got them on edge.
Okay, dog. Again, this is the only time you'll get in this property. As if I need help. Whistle and nobody shows up anyway, so what's the point? Do it all by yourself. Place where I'm at. these Redlock bunch are better than me.
Thanks to your efforts, order and peace are restored. Crosswitch will be back to normal in no time. At last, Sternus Gelves has paid for his crimes against Crosswitch, Eaglesbrook, and my family. This town, and I.
Time for me to head back to the mine. We'll take care of any Red Rooks stupid enough to stick around.
We need to make plans. This sort of thing must never
happen. How's that done? So that should now be coloured in there. Yeah. Okay, let's see what we've got. Into heavy two-handed at the moment, so let's go and talk to that ghosty then. Where was he? do you, money?
We cannot resist much longer.
We can't resist. We can't resist much longer. Soon we'll be forced to answer. Our masters were the ancient rulers of Hyrok, at rest these many years. Now, Bloodthorn cultists have disturbed the burial mounds and stolen the ruling regalia from the tombs of our kings. We can't stop them. The Bloodthorn drain our wills. If you recover the regalia they stole and return it to the crypts, it will restore our leaders. They are strong spirits, and our joined wills can resist the cultists. I sense the regalia. It is still nearby. These Bloodthorn are nothing more than grave robbers. Take back the regalia they stole and return each item to its proper tomb. They hide the items in the groundskeeper's cottage, south of the burial mounds. To control our ancient kings, just as they try to control us. We were at peace, stranger, silent in watchful slumber. Then the screaming began. Not us. At least not at first. They were loud, insistent voices, crying in our minds. Screaming, submit, submit. They broke our will and shattered our defenses. They want us to join them. They're servants of Molag Bal. They seek to conquer Glenumbra. Please stop them. We won't be able to resist the Bloodthorn much longer.
Alright, Ghosty, don't worry. Me and Rufus are on this. Might have noticed that I do things. Some things like when I'm in more than fight, when it's more than a one-on-one fight, pop your bow out. Obviously that gives extra damage. And then when I'm in a fight, if you've got like a mage or an archer, I always go for them first. Candles or coins? Oh, that is a backpack. I always tend to go for them first. They're the ones that alert you the most, so I always recommend go for them first. The likes of them guys, they'll hurt you, but if you got enough armor on, you should be alright. Didn't even see him then. Oi. How dare you disturb me while I'm trying to pick flowers? God, come to somewhere you can't even pick flowers these days. Zombie trying to chew your leg off, or somebody whacking you with a sword. I don't know.
Aisa, she was our beloved ruler, a queen with martial skills and unsurpassed beauty. Her shield, the Green Aegis, protected her in battle. It was the symbol of our undying loyalty to her.
Yeah, I'm there for shit out.
More, the Green Aegis defends its lady's resting place.
Your enemy. Wait, I'm not your enemy. I'm hiding. I didn't know the Bloodthorns were going to desecrate this burial site. My ancestors are buried here. My great-great-grandfather appeared before me, demanded I atone for the desecration. If I don't, he said he'd haunt me forever. I made a mistake when I joined them. If I go back out there, they'll kill me. Please, help me appease my ancestors. The Bloodthorns stole sacred candles from the tombs. Retrieve them and light them at my family tomb so they know I still honor them. Look for the tombs of the Windvale Patriarch, Matriarch, and the Scion. They were very important in their time. I'd suggest honoring the Windvale Founder's tomb last. He was really angry, scared me witless when he just appeared out of nowhere. I'm going to do whatever I can to make up for my mistakes. I'll get out of here and go home to Daggerfall. Find something useful to do, maybe help my father at his tailor shop. I certainly won't be joining any other cults in the near future because of Angoth. He seemed like the strong leader that Glenumbra so desperately needs. He can be very persuasive. I never thought about the harm we were doing until the ghost of my own ancestor confronted me. Of course I am. I'm so scared, I can't think straight. Look for the tomb.
I'll go away. Sick of bored now. Right. Pick that one up and might as well do that as we're going along.
His treasures.
And if we buy one of them. Want one for my house. A doorbell. Ghosting. I've got time.
Once more, the Bride of the Golden Prince protects his treasures.
Oh.
candle's face, you loon.
Again, the Iron King's flame will burn those who try to steal his blade. I won't be afraid any longer. It's time to do something about the Red Rooks.
Fine, no Whisperer.
Sheathe your weapon. I may be dead, but I am not your enemy. Mortal, know that I am Donel Delan, once King of Daggerfall. Your deeds have not gone unnoticed, and I thank you for your help. However, the danger has not passed. These necromancers plan to enslave us and turn us against our descendants. The Bloodthorn no longer desecrate our tombs, but our faithful knights are still at risk. The grave robbers use soul-twisting sorcery. Slay these Bloodthorn cultists. Rescue the spirits they are trying to enslave. To my great sorrow, Sir Grandin has already heeded their evil call. Find his tomb to the east and destroy him. When that is done, find me on the Monument Hill. Slay the Bloodthorns. Break their hold over our servants. Our servants have been loyal and true. Such commitment must not be repaid with slavery. Sir Grandin was a great hero of High Rock. Standing alone in the pass to Stormhaven, he turned back the raging Nord invaders. As the first spirit to fall to the Bloodthorns, would be a fearsome opponent.
Right. See my spirits alone.
The screams have ended and I can think again. Must attend to my lords.
Move now.
You're going down.
At long last, my thoughts are once again my own. Thanks to you.
Thank you, champion. Your help is greatly appreciated.
Right, let's go and kill Chief Ghost. Disappeared now. Chest.
showing off now.
You return. My brother and sister monarchs await word of your success. We knew you could defeat the Bloodthorn cultists, and now the time has come. Please remain. Without your aid, we'd be slaves, forced by the Bloodthorns to smite our own descendants. Even kings may bend a knee to those they honor. Release us to our final rest. Have we your leave to depart? Farewell, mortal. Your actions this day shall prove a decisive blow to the Bloodthorn cult and their evil master.
Bye bye, ghosties. Ooh, big drop. Ooh. Always feel good after you killed zombies. The others testing.
What's this? You're not my idiot descendant. You're not even a member of my family. You're placing the sacred candles instead of my worthless descendant? Has he no shame at all? I can see that. So he's afraid to face his former comrades? He should fear the wrath of the angry dead more. Still, he has made an effort of a sort. Return to Harum. Tell him to renounce the cult and continue to make amends, or he'll suffer the vengeance of the dead. Now go. I wish to return to my rest.
Hey, grumpy old sod. I like him.
What did great-grandfather tell you? Am I back in good graces? I renounce the cult and promise to honor my ancestors, but from a much safer distance. I'll make my way out of here. Maybe go to Daggerfall or start a new life somewhere else. No more cults for me. Not even benign ones.
Right, good lad. Go on. Off you go. Right, guys. I think I'll follow in his footsteps and I'll die. So that's all come up as well now. We haven't got that many to go. I think I'll call it a night myself. No, I want to go to Daggerfall. Let's whiff over to Daggerfall. See if we can beat that fella. And strip down all my stuff and that I don't want. Empty me pockets. This is my call on night. We haven't got that many now. So I think what we'll do next stream is finish off the side missions, and then we'll go and do some sky shard hunting. Better still, I think I'll do a 3D run. When I mean 3D, I mean Dolmens, Delves and Dungeons. Let's see if Stylish and Will want to join me. Yeah, I think I'll do that, but better idea. Right, okay guys, so let's make sure.
My horse.
Yeah, it's Jamie horses. So as I said, we're going to call it a night then. So thanks for joining me. And as usual guys, I'll catch you all later.